biology.
Yes, hello there and welcome to this class whereby we are going to discuss about the components of the mammalian circulatory system. So you see that the blood circulatory system of mammals mainly comprises of the arteries, you have the veins and you have the capillaries, including a very muscular heart. So the arteries, veins and the capillaries are known as blood vessels. So let's begin with looking at the arteries. So from the arteries you see that they transport blood from the heart. So they also carry oxygenated blood to all parts of the body from the heart except the pulmonary artery, which is the only artery that carries deoxygenated blood. So we also see that the arteries are very much muscular and inelastic with a very small lumen. So blood flows in them at very high pressure. And this explains why they have a very narrow lumen and they are also very muscular, as the diagram shows. So let's now look at the veins. So you see that the veins are less muscular and they are very much elastic as compared to the arteries. So blood flows in the veins at very low pressure. And at vein intervals, you are going to find we have valves. What is the function of the valves located in the veins? So their function is to prevent the backflow of blood, since blood in them is flowing at very low pressure. So you also see that a tiny vein is known as a venule. So many venules unite now to form now the main vein. So let's now look at the differences between the arteries and the veins. So what are the differences between arteries and veins? So for the arteries, we see that they have a thick muscular wall, and for the veins, they have a very thin, and less muscular wall. For the arteries, we see that they have a very narrow lumen as compared to the veins, which have a very wide lumen. So for the arteries, they don't have any valves, and for the veins, they have valves at different intervals. And we say that the function of the valves is to prevent the backflow of blood. So for the arteries, we also see that they transport blood away from the heart, while for the veins, they bring blood back to the heart. So for the arteries also, we see that they mainly transport the oxygenated blood except the pulmonary artery, which is the only artery that transports deoxygenated blood. And also, when you look at the veins, you see that the veins carry deoxygenated blood except the pulmonary vein, which is the only vein that carries oxygenated blood. So for the arteries, we also see that blood flows in them at very high pressure as compared to veins, whereby blood flows in them at very low pressure. Also for the arteries, you see that the blood flows in pulses as the heart is beating, while for the veins, blood flows very smoothly. So now let's go to the next one, which is capillaries. So let's look at capillaries. So for the capillaries, you see that there are small 1 cm thick blood vessels that are located between the cells of every organ in the body, organ or tissue, or the cells in the body. So they join an arterial with the venule. And if you can remember the previous class, we said that for the blood vessels, we have the arteries, we have arterioles, which are now the small arteries. From the arterioles, we now have the capillaries, which now the capillaries join to the tissues and the cells of the body. Now, from the capillaries, we now have the venules, which are small veins, and then the venules unite now to form now the vein, which brings blood back to the heart. So, what are the adaptations of capillaries to their function? So, first of all, we see that they have direct contact with tissues and cells for efficient exchange of materials. So, they are also very numerous to increase the surface area over which exchange of materials is going to take place in the body. So also we see that the capillaries are 1 cm thick for easier diffusion of materials to or from the capillaries and the cells and the tissues. So they also have a very thin lumen to increase the pressure, hence allow materials to diffuse out of them or into them very fast. So finally, let's look at the capillary mechanism of exchange. So how do exchange of materials happen between capillaries and the tissue? So first of all, we see that they run close to the cells since they have a very small or a very tiny lumen. So some part of the blood is filtered into the cell, whereby this blood that is filtered into the cell is always known as tissue fluid. So blood left to the capillaries have more solute concentration, hence they are highly concentrated. So the waste in the cellular space is diffused out, or rather, they diffuse out into the capillaries from the tissue. The food and the nutrients as well will diffuse in the cells, and then the waste products from the cells and the tissue will enter into the capillaries. So let's meet on the next class as we now begin to discuss more regarding the heart as far as circulatory system is concerned. Biology.